Good morning, children. Hope you all are fine. I welcome you all to today's session of maths, and we are still on chapter 7, fractions. In my previous session, we had recalled what we studied in class 4. Then we saw how to reduce the fractions to the lowest term by dividing numerator and denominator by a common number, right? Then we also saw what are the types of fractions. We saw two types, proper, improper, and mixed. Three types. Proper when the numerator is less than the denominator, improper when the numerator is more than the denominator, mixed when the fraction is having a numerical as well as a fractional part, right? And we also saw how to represent an improper fraction as mixed fraction. We divided the numerator by denominator and we wrote the quotient in front, remainder as the numerator, and then denominator will be the divisor, right? So after doing exercise 7.2, let us start by comparison of fractions, right? We all know why whenever we compare things, we need more than one quantity. So when we compare two whole numbers, we wish to find whether they are equal or unequal. If they are unequal, we usually go a step further and decide which of the two is greater. Similarly, in a comparison of two fractional numbers, we decide whether they are equal or not. And if unequal, then we should say which is the greater of the two. We have sure method of dealing with this problem. We divide fractions into three types. Fraction having same denominator, fractions having same numerator, and fractions whose numerator and denominator are different. Right? Now, children, the first and second one are a little bit easier, and the third one is a little bit tricky, right? Okay. Now, if the denominator is the same, I give you one hint. If the denominator is the same, then the fraction whose numerator is the least, that fraction is the lowest, and the fraction whose numerator is the greater value or greatest value is the highest. Now see here, 1 upon 5th, only one portion is shaded. In this, see, there is an entire rod here. This rod is divided into 5 segments. Right, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. See, one part of it is shaded and the remaining 4 are vacant, right? So this is 1 upon 5, then 2 upon 5. Now the dark portion, just see that, which is greater, 2 upon 5 or 1 upon 5? You will find that the great dark part of 2 upon 5 is greater, because 2 is greater than 1. Similarly, 3 upon 5, now 3 upon 5 is the greater one. 4 upon 5, 4 upon 5 is, of the 4, 4 upon 5 is the greatest, because 4 is greatest of the four numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So we will be writing it as, in a comparative form, we will be writing it like this. 2 upon 5 is greater than 1 upon 5, then 3 upon 5 is greater than 2 upon 5, or 4 upon 5 is greater than 3 upon 5, and also like this. 1 upon 5 is less than 2 upon 5, 2 upon 5 is less than 3 upon 5. And 3 upon 5 is less than 4 upon 5. If two fractions have same denominator but different numerator. Now, in this, if we have to write all the 4, how we will be writing? Right? See, we will be writing it as 4 upon 5 is greater than 3 upon 5. Is greater than 2 upon 5 is greater than 1 upon 5, right? And vice versa also, right? Like 1 upon 5 is less than 2 upon 5 is less than 3 upon 5 is less than 4 upon 5. That is when we are comparing all 4. means ascending or descending order. Ascending order is lowest to highest, and descending is highest to lowest. Now, if the numerator is the same, what about the denominator? Now, 1 upon 2, see, it is just the opposite of the previous one when denominator is the same. When denominator is the same, the bigger the numerator, the bigger is the number, the bigger is the fraction. When the numerator is the same and denominator change, the greater the denominator, the smaller is the fraction. Right? See here, the first one is 1 upon 2, the second one 1 upon 3, it's then 1 upon 4, and then 1 upon 5. And you can see the shaded portion, 1 upon 2 is the largest and 1 upon 5 is the smallest. Where 5 is larger than definitely 2. So it's just the opposite of that, right, children? Right? So if two fractions have the same numerator and but different denominators, the one having the smaller denominator is greater than the other one. Right, children? Okay. Now we have to compare between fractions with different numerators and denominators. Right? Then what to do? 1 upon 4 and 2 upon 3. Now what comparison is only possible if denominator or numerator becomes the same. Easiest is when we have the same denominator. Now for that, what we should do is, whenever there are two fractions with different denominators, we should take LCM of that. Right? We should take LCM of that and try to convert the fraction having the same denominator, which should be the LCM. Right? Another technique is we multiply the two denominators. Right? We multiply. So here it is 1 upon 4 and 2 upon 3. We get 4 into 3 as 12. 4 into 3 as 12. Now we should try to convert the denominators to be 12. For that, we need to multiply. See how we need to do is, this question is 1 upon 4 and 2 upon 3, right? So 1 upon 4, if we want to convert it into 12, what we should be doing is, we know 4, 3 is 12, so we will multiply numerator and denominator by 3 and to get 3 upon 12. 2 upon 3 then, so we will get 6 upon, sorry, so 1 upon 4 was okay. Now we found that 1 upon 4 becomes 3 upon 12. But when we are taking 2 upon 3 into account, we know 3, 4 is 12. So we will be multiplying the numerator and denominator by 4 now. So we will be getting 8 upon 12. Right? Now, which of the two is bigger? We have seen when the denominator is the same, the greater the numerator, the bigger the fraction. So 8 upon 12 will be greater than 3 upon 12, right? So we will write here 8, like see here it is written, 8 upon 12 is greater than 3 upon 12, right? Okay. So how to compare the mixed fraction? Right? It is very simple that firstly, as in the second case, the denominator is the same. So when the denominator is the same, then the number which is having the greater whole number is the larger number, or the number which is having numerator greater numerator is the larger number. But if the denominator is different, see in the A case, now how we should do it, we should firstly convert them into improper fraction and then the previous step should be adopted, taking the LCM and then converting it. Right? Now see this example 6. Riya read 25 pages of a book containing 100 pages. Lalita read one half of the same book. Who has read it the least, right? So firstly, what we will be doing, we will be making out the fraction of Riya. So for that, what is done here is, see children, okay, the question becomes hidden. See here, the fraction of Riya is being calculated by putting 25 as numerator and total 100 pages are there, so 100 will be the denominator and the fraction becomes 1/4. The fraction of the book read by Lalita is 1/2. Now of 1/2 and 1/4, right, what they have done is, which is the greater? So we tried to make the numerator denominator same, and how we have done 1/2, how we know how it becomes 4, we multiply numerator and denominator by 2, so we get 2/4. So now the two fractions are 2/4 and 1/4, and we all know the numerator of 2/4 is greater, so that fraction is also greater, right? Now we should move to exercise 7.3, right? So we should do the exercise 7.3 first, right children? Now in this, which is the greater? We take into account the first one, 1/3 or 1/5, right? See, numerator is the same in the first one, so the greater the denominator, the smaller is the number, so 1/3 is greater than 1/5, right? In the second one, denominator is same, numerator is different, right? So 3, the numerator being more, will be greater. 3/7 is greater than 2/7. Similarly, we will be continuing to do it. Now we will come to a point where the numerators are different, 3/8 and 5/9, right? See, I will be doing this question. So 3/8, right? Just a minute. 3/8 and 5/9. So I will be writing 3/8, and I know, and the second one is 5/9. I know 8 9s are 72. So I need to convert that 2 into 72. So I will be multiplying the numerator and denominator of the first one by 9 and the numerator and denominator of the second one by 8. Right? So here I will be getting 27/72, and here I will be getting 40/72, right? And we all know 40/72 is always greater than 27/72, right? This is how, for the fraction which are in mixed form, you convert them into improper form and adopt the same strategy, ascending, descending, right? So you can do this exercise on your own as I move ahead to addition of fractions, right? Which I think we should take in the next session. So I stop here. Hope you all enjoyed it as much as I did in making it. And until we meet again, it's a goodbye.